What's up, guys? I'm Just a Gamer, and I'm back with another reaction video. Forspoken has released another deep dive video, this one into Magic Combat. And as you know, the game is looking better and better to me since they first showed it off. I'm actually really looking forward to it now. It's one of my games that I'm really excited to play next year. So yeah, I'm really excited to see this. If you're enjoying any of my content, please leave a like or comment down below. I appreciate any and all feedback. I'm streaming on Twitch now, so please consider following me there as well at twitch.tv/justagamerinc. INC at the end, or click below. But yeah, enough of me talking. Let's get into it.
This is Athia, home to treacherous landscapes, corrupted beasts, and menacing threats. To survive in this wicked environment, Frey must learn how to master an arsenal of magical abilities. There are multiple types of spells Frey can learn to deploy, and each type of magic will have its own array of attack, support, and parkour skills. Frey will have access to the base spells of each magic type, with powerful upgrades available to earn by collecting mana. At the onset of her journey, Frey discovers the earth-based purple magic.
Hold on. I don't know why, but like, for whatever reason, this is not looking too... It's 1080. So let's just crank up to 4K, even though I don't think I can catch that. Anyway, another thing I want to just make a quick mention is I'm actually liking the variety of enemies. Like, before we didn't really see much, we just saw like a few mutated animals and stuff like that, but I've been really enjoying the variety of enemies we've seen in the various videos so far.
Attack spell for this magic is known as Shock, and by charging up Shock, Frey can unleash more powerful attacks. Burst Shock fires clusters of explosive rock. Shield Shock creates a defensive barrier while charging and explodes into smaller particles when released. Scattershot unloads a steady stream of rocks, then quickly triggers a high-impact, long-range projectile.
That's kind of cool.
Magic also provides her with support spells that come in handy in a variety of ways. For example, Prime sets up explosive traps. Scream generates a force field. And Tendril heals, based on how much damage it does. For more defensive-minded players, Frey has a host of abilities that provide her with survivability in battle. Learning how to dodge attacks with magic parkour is the key to defeating the corrupted threats of Athia. But when she does get struck, Frey's trusty sidekick, Cuff, will take the hit to reduce the damage dealt and create an opportunity for a counterattack. Cuff can also be extremely useful before any enemy encounter occurs. With Cuff's assistance, Frey can scan the area for nearby points of interest and potential threats. Cuff can examine enemies to provide valuable intel on their strengths and weaknesses.
Every open world needs kind of that. Not every.
Later into Frey's journey, she will unlock fire-based red magic, and these spells open up new ways to play. Spells like Fusillade, Aegis, and Legion are strong defensive options. But sometimes a strong offense is the best defense. Red magic gives Frey the ability to unleash some devastating melee attacks. The quick attack spell for red magic bestows Frey with a magical blade called Slice. A charged up Slice unleashes the magic attacks Arc, Blast, and Rage Slice. Additionally, the red magic support spells provide various offensive capabilities, such as Charge and Bombardier. In addition to purple and red magic, Frey will gain access to blue and green magic as she progresses on her journey. These magic types also offer a multitude of attack and support spells for Frey to master.
I'm blown away by the variety.
Support spells gradually charges Frey's surge magic, eventually enabling her to cast an extra powerful spell. Used at the right moment, it can wipe out an entire opposing force in one fell swoop.
Frey can also choose to end an opponent by dealing a killer blow. A devastating move she can perform when an enemy is stunned on the ground. Experimenting with different magic types and abilities allows Frey to tailor her combat style to suit any perilous situation. With a wide range of magical abilities at her disposal, Frey will have a multitude of ways to deal with any situation she may encounter. Only after mastering these new abilities will she be able to defend Athia against the corrupting force of the Break. And perhaps find a way back home.
All right, that was Forspoken's deep dive into magic combat. And yeah, again, I've been saying it over and over. The game is looking better and better every time I see it. The variety of enemies they showed is like really good and really fascinating. And especially that one giant one they showed in the very beginning with like three tongues and all that. That looked crazy and it looked like it might be fun to fight. And again, I'm just blown away by like just the variety of different magics that each category has. I mean, I have to assume some of them are going to eventually overlap and be similar in some sense, because if all of them are that unique, I am just going to be blown away. But yeah, again, game is looking really good. Can't wait to play it. And I'm really excited. So those are my thoughts. That's my reaction. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like or comment down below. I'd appreciate any and all feedback. I'm streaming on Twitch now, so please consider following me there as well at twitch.tv/justgamerinc. INC at the end, or click the below. But yeah, follow, subscribe, all that good stuff. And until next time, take care and have a good game.